Hi everybody, I'm Marina. Welcome to my Ceramics Oasis channel, and today I will tell you how to build bird sitting on a wood log. For this project, I'm going to use air dry clay Aurora in red color. I will start from wooden base, and for wooden base I will need piece of clay, and I start from ball. Flat it, and I try to make cylinder. Short cylinder. Place my finger inside. And make like a cup. Put it upside down. And for base, I have to add couple branches. So for couple branches, I will build coil first. Cut it. And I will connect branches around this trunk. For connecting, I have to score, add water, and place branch to the trunk. Also, it's a good idea to add reinforcing coil around this branch. Also, score, add water, detach. Again, add reinforcing coil. I think it's too long, so I can make it shorter. And might be I will add longer one. Let's see. Yeah. Again, score. Add water. Connect. And do not forget about reinforcing coil. I make another coil and put it on the top to show bark and middle part. Okay. So here's my general shape, and next step is to add texture, wooden texture, to my project. So I use this tool, knife and carving tool, and I make few lines, just pretend it's wood. And here is supposed to be rings and trays. Next step, I switch my tool and I'm going to use metallic brush. I follow this line's direction. And here's I'm going to add million dots. Take my knife and repeat these lines again. I made this line deeper. Okay, so here's my base, like pedestal for my bird. Don't forget, take two sticks. I took two chopsticks. And I put them inside of my base. So it will be armature to place my bird on the top, to hold all my construction. Hold bird here. See you in couple days. Let your base dry and I will show you how to build bird body. So yesterday we finished our base. It's like a little piece of wood or log. We add texture and we add two sticks, and we're going to use the sticks for armature, for our construction, for our sculpture. And today I'm going to build toucan. Here's my reference, and I have front view and side view. To build this project, I'm going to make a quick sketch first. So, for body, I'm going to build all like egg shape. For head, I'm going to build cup. And for tail, it's like trapezoid shape, right? And for wings, it's like triangular shapes. So I will start from body, and after it I will connect head, tail, and of course for toucan I have to build huge, big. Okay, let's start from body. And I create egg shape. I work with air dry clay, so I can build it solid. However, if I will build it solid, it will dry forever. So I take tool. You can use a tool like this, or you can use any brush. Put it inside and make it hollow. And I will close the shape. Okay. Next part will be head, and I take piece of clay, make sphere or ball, put my finger inside, and build tiny cup. A little bit longer. Okay, hole here, score, add water, place this cup, and I'm going to connect it. I can use rib. And next step, I'm going to add tail. For tail, I will need piece of clay. Okay. And I will build flat trapezoid. Okay. Score. Add water, place tail here, and connect. I turn it upside down. Take piece of clay and use it like reinforcing coil. Place it here, and smooth in both directions. So I got general shape for my bird. Next step, I'm going to add feet and fingers. So for fingers, let me move my bending wheel slightly. You can see. For fingers, I'm going to use coil, and I cut this coil for 6 parts. Took this tool and show nails. Okay, connect 3 of them together. Can you see? Score. Add water. And I will place it in the front of my stick. Okay, water here, score here, again water here, place it next to my stick. Okay, for next step I'm going to connect base and connect my bird. So I find right position and just push my bird on the sticks. Okay, and I'm going to use a camper tool and add feather texture before I add wings and a beak. Hold it. Okay, next step I'm going to add wings, and for wings I will take piece of clay, make coil, and it's supposed to be pointy coil. Okay, let it and cut it, flat it again, bend it slightly, remove extra. Okay, and let's estimate, is this okay or it's too small or it's too big? Let's see. I think that's good. Mm-hmm. Again, I will score here and I will score here. Add water here and add water here. And it's really thick, but I would like to keep it like this because I will overlap this material over body and I would add texture here. Okay, and I start again to add texture, like feather texture for wings. If you do not have a camper tool, you can use brush handle Okay. And my last part is big, and it's really big, huge. So I'm going to make it hollow. Take brush, put brush inside, make it hollow, make hole here, score, add water, and place this big, let's shape it better. Because this part is really big, I'm going to use reinforcing coil and add it around. I'm trying to make bigger smooth and I still shape it. You can see reference. And for shaping, I love to use rice spoon. And also metallic ribs. And plastic ribs. And for eyes, I will use camper tool again. I will show you two different ways. You can use brush, make hole. Or you can use camper tool. Also, let me show what's that. Just create little circle. And for birds, usually you can find or you can see little like called brows like this. And you can see a little ridge here. So take piece of clay and add it right before beak. Also, I want to show this beak has two parts, so I just carve line in the middle. You can see. And from another side also. Okay, I add texture around this bird. And actually, beak might be a little bit bigger, but because stability for my sculpture is really important and I try to keep it stable, so I decide intentional make it slightly smaller. Otherwise, what will happen? You can see. Okay, I'm almost done. We'll spend a little bit more time smooth beak. And oops, you can see. Let's change shape to make it more stable. Okay, and I will let my project dry for probably 3 or 4 days and I will start paint it. Hi everybody, 4 days later my project is completely dry and I spray it by sealer to make it more strong and durable. And now I'm going to paint it. So I will start from base, and for base I will use two colors. I will use Born Amber and unbleached titanium. I will start from Born Amber. I premix my Born Amber with water, and I use medium size brush, and I start at dark color because Born Amber is very very dark brown to my base, to my wood. Some areas I try to make deeper, darker, and another I would keep reddish color, preserve clay color. Okay. Let's make this bark a little bit darker than a medium part. And now I'm going to use unbleached titanium. But you can use any beige color if you do not have any titanium. And I keep my brush flat and just gentle touch wood surface to show texture. I think that's it. I will let it dry, and next step I will paint my bird. So my base is now completely dry. I use hair dryer and dry it, and I keep my reference next to me, and I'm going to follow these colors. So I will need just four colors: white, black, red, orange, and blue for feet. And I will start from white. And even this biggest orange, I'm going to paint it with white first. And do not miss area under this beak, so you can hold your project and paint here. Probably you will need two or three layers for full coverage. I start from first, finish it. And also I will paint this white spot with white. I try to make the spots symmetrical. And we'll add one more layer. Until my white color is drying, I'm going to paint feet, and you can see it's blue. It's bluish color, light blue. So I probably will use this one. Let's check half a tail ear. It's actually too bright, and I will add a little bit black to my blue. Let's see what will happen. Yeah, now I got good grayish blue, just a little bit white, and I can use this color for feet. I switch my brush for smaller size. Okay, and again I'm going to use hair dryer and dry my bird. Okay, we'll add one more layer for beak and for spots. Let it dry again. Okay, and it's time to start use black color. I take medium size brush, and first I'm going to paint head, and be very very careful. You can overlap white color slightly. And now I can change my brush for bigger size. Also, you will need 2 or 3 coats. Now I switch my brush again for smaller size, because I'm going to work around this feet and wood. I try to reach everywhere, under the wings, also under the tail. Okay, let's add one more coat. And now I'm going to start working on details. I'm going to paint beak and also add eyes and 2 spots on the beak. So I will need 2 colors, and I will use yellow, oops, and red, and I will mix them. So you can see beak is not actually solid. You can see yellow stripe here and reddish color under this beak. So I'm going to start from lightest color and blend it with red color. Okay, we'll use orange first. And reddish color on the bottom. You can work back and forth, back and forth, and build your color, make it more realistic. Also, be gentle, turn it upside down, and paint beak on the bottom. A little bit reddish color. Again. Orange. Put it back. Because you use acrylic, you can work over this color. And also I would add a little bit reddish orangey color for head areas. Okay, I would like more yellow on the top. Okay, let's dry again. And now I'm going to add few details. You can see this black stripe around beak. These two spots and eyes. I took tiny brush. Just apply black color over yellow. You can hold your bird. And for eyes, I'm going to just add black dots. And for beak, these spots, I again switch to tiny brush. And we'll paint these dots, spots actually. So I finished my toucan today. I finished painting and now I can decorate my room. Guys, I just want to let you know, you can build any bird using this technique. You can build a crow, you can build owl or any other bird. Just keep reference next to you and follow proportions. I hope you had fun and see you next week. Bye-bye.